Hey guys, welcome back to my project, I'm Eric here. Following the previous project, I'd like to talk about the image format today. There are some options that we can use from ESP32CAM. Comparing RGB565 and JPEG, we will find the best option for the current system. Two major bottlenecks occur when images are received from ESP32CAM and printed on TTGO's screen. If we can solve these problems, I think we can refresh the screen faster by reducing the latency. So the test I prepared today is about image first. To print out the JPEG image, we need to decode this, but there is a delay in this part. I thought using RGB565 format instead of JPEG would reduce latency because JPEG decoding time is not required. We will focus on this and see the result. Let's get started. Before we begin, let me tell you what was wrong in the previous video. I got the X and Y coordinates to put the image in the center right. However, I miscalculated the start X coordinates. It's my bad. The starting coordinates of the X axis must be minus 40 instead of minus 30 to be the center of the incoming image from ES32CAM with the resolution 320 by 240. I have put the revised code on my project GitHub. Please check it again if you need it. And one more thing, the raster resolution part of the ESP32CAM. I told you in the previous video that the raster image is QVJ, which is 320 by 240, but it's wrong. The raster is 96 by 96. I'm sorry for the wrong information. Here is a comment from one of my subscribers. After receiving the image from ESP32CAM in RGB565 format rather than JPEG, TTGO outputs the image directly to display. Without decoding JPEG, we can push the image into the LCD directory. RGB565 represents 16 bits of the pure pixel information. That is, 16 bits are required to show a single pixel color. This idea made me blow my mind. If you don't use the JPEG decoder, we can reduce the latency for drawing for an image, right? Let's take a look at the source code I prepared and show you how ESP32CAM setup for RGB565 and TTGO output the image. On the left is the ESP32CAM source code and on the right is the TTGO source code. You can change the image output format by touching a few options. Change the pixel format to RGB565 of course. Also the resolution is QQVGA which is 160 by 120. I will have a test with this resolution for all cases today. This FV count is for the number of the frame buffers to be allocated. You can assign more than one in JPEG mode only. So we have to set it 1. Lastly, checking if the format is RGB565 one more time before sending. That's all for the ESP32CAM for RGB565. TTGO became much simpler. All you have to do is push the center data directly to the display. One thing you have to do is to change the set swipe bytes of TFT to false. For JPEG, usually the order of the bytes is big endian, so you need to correct the order with this setSwipeByte function. Whereas for RGB565, all data are stored in a reader endian format, so we don't need to use this function to output it correctly, so it should be false. Go to the drawing part in the loop. You can output image data directly to the screen using TFT push image function without using decoder. This is great. Okay, already let's see the result. The left screen is RGB565 format and the right screen is the existing JPEG format from the previous project. Both of them have a resolution of 160 by 120. There is one thing I overlooked in the RGB565 format, it's the file size. The size of data is bound to big because it's not compressed with one pixel of information intact. 16 bits or 2 bytes are required to represent one pixel in the image. The current resolution is 160 by 120, so if you calculate 160 by 120 by 2, the size of the single image is 38.4 kilobytes. What is the RGB565 though? RGB565 means 5-bit red, 6-bit green, and 5-bit blue. RGB24 is made of 8-bit red, 8-bit green, and 8-bit blue. With RGB565, the possible color space is limited. The green color component can charge in 64 steps, but the red and blue components can only charge in 32 steps. Eventually, the larger amount of the data affects the network transfer time. Because of the file size, it takes about 150 milliseconds to get an image. This is an unexpected result. In order to take advantage of RGB565, we need to be a standalone device. For example, if the device is directly connected to the ESP32CAM, uplink to RGB565 format rather than JPEG format will significantly reduce the delay. I think this part can be handled separately by other projects. Anyway, on the right is the only resolution changed in the previous project. Although it's very low resolution image, it takes about 25 milliseconds to print one sheet. As the resolution highs, the time increases. Since JPEG compression is done, the data size is smaller, so the network transfer time is shorter than the previous original one. Overall, it takes around 40 milliseconds to print one image, which is about 25 frames per second. This is not the end of today's project. Let's try to push it a little bit more. The JPEG decoder we are currently using is a TJPEG decoder. I think this is the best JPEG decoder for ESP32 or other Arduino boards. Here is a decoder approach using dual core made for ESP32. Using this, JPEG decoding time can be reduced. Here is my source code. You can download it through the link below. From the existing example source code, I modified the part I needed. The existing code only continues to draw one dummy image file. Instead of dummy one, I changed it so that it's possible to process the image we received with Websocket. The way it behaves is simple. It makes a dedicated core for the decoding task so that outputs it to the screen only through this task. The core works separately, so it's possible to reduce the latency when drawing on the screen. It's a really nice concept, isn't it? The rest are all the same. I think if we configure the entire system with free R2S, we will get better performance. Let me show you this result. The screen on the left is using the dedicated core for JPEG decoding. The screen on the right is the same as before. The time to draw one image in the same environment has been faster. It's great. I think there will be more obvious difference if I draw a much bigger image. I don't know why, but it feels like there's more network delay. It's the same system as the first intro video, but I think it's coming out a little bit slower in this video. If we change the entire system to task-based, we can see more definite effect. Let's summarize today's project. RGB565 format is disadvantageous under network situations. However, it's expected that it'll be very fast in a standalone devices. When using JPEG decoder, the dedicated core for JPEG decoding can reduce latency. I'd love to get any comments on my project. If you have, please leave it here. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.